typecast in C++. So what was a class? It meant to change the data type of an object. Potentially, it also means to change the data representation. For example, when you have a two complement number such as integer and you try to change this number into a double type. So there are implicit casts that are performed by the compiler and explicit casts that are performed by the programmer and requested. C++ standard is much more strict than C standard, so you may encounter some mistakes when you don't use explicit casts in C++, while in C they would be accepted and done implicitly by the compiler. What is new in C++ is that we have to think about casting objects that have a parent-child inheritance relationship. So in terms of objects, we could talk about an upcast, which means we try to treat a child class as an object from the parent. So as we know, a student, for example, if that is a person, then wherever you can use a person object, you can use a student as well because of this relationship. So in the hierarchy, a student is more down than the person. That's why it's called upcast. Upcast because we cast it up in such a hierarchy of objects. So this automatically works if you have a relation and use public inheritance. Yeah, if you use any other private or protected inheritance, we know we change our is a relationship to a has a relationship, and then this cannot work anymore. So then we have the downcast, which means when we have a base object, a reference or a pointer to a base object, and we know this is not only this base object, it's not just a person, it is a student in fact, then we may want to cast this object to a derived child object such as student. So generally speaking, there are various levels of casts in C++. So the first level is a const cast, which removes just const of a data type. Next, we have a static cast that performs possible implicit and explicit conversions. Then we have reinterpret cast, which treats data in another type, converting the data, for example, from a pointer to a double. And lastly, we have the dynamic cast, which casts an object from one object type to another. It uses the so-called RTTI, which stands for runtime type information. So in terms of syntax, how you can apply those casts, these are the levels of casts that are supported by C++, but there are also templates that allow you to perform the casts. So I can, for example, take an expression and then I apply on this expression a const cast, and at the end I want to get an integer out. So integer is the target of my cast. And we can still use the C-like casting in most cases where we had said int in brackets for our expression, and then the result of this expression would be converted to an integer. Yeah, if I do that, C kind of casting, the compiler applies the first cast in the list. So it would try const cast, it would try static cast, and lastly reinterpret cast. But if none of them work, it would have stopped. The dynamic casts, they are not checked with such an implicit formulation. Generally, it's good practice to use those C++ casts as they make the intent explicit. So if I use a const cast, it's clear I want to remove const. I want to perform some conversion implicitly or explicitly of some data without changing its bad meaning, or I want to reinterpret the bits in the data type. Here are some basic examples. So I have a double value d with some value, and I have a pointer p of type void. So here we can do a static cast, for example, to an integer pointer. So after I have assigned here the address to p, so our void pointer, I don't know the type anymore, but I can say this pointer was in fact of type int pointer. So I use instar as in this template static cast, and so I will return an int pointer. If I have a const, for example, a const pointer in this example, then I can remove the const by using a const cast with the respective data type. Yeah, so here I will get an instar back by removing the const. So the reinterpret cast, what I want to do, for example, in this example, is that I want to reinterpret a number to be a pointer. So that is really a hard conversion because it normally shouldn't be allowed. It's dangerous and so on. So therefore I need to reinterpret cast, and I do this by specifying I want to have a void pointer back. Well, here you go. And I can say from such a void pointer, I want to get back a size T object again, which is a data type, and I use another reinterpret cast. Yeah, now we can use static cast for objects as well. Let's have a look at this little class hierarchy over here. We have a parent, there's a function hello, it just says parent, and child, there's a function hello that returns child. Both are strings, so these are kind of the same methods, and they return a const string. They are const. That means they do not change the object. We'll talk about this in a second. So forget about it. So how can we use this? Well, we create a child C, and the child, of course, is also a parent, yeah? And for a child, I can say C.hello. Well, this will print child, yeah? Then I can create a reference to a parent. This is allowed, and this variable now is assigned to C. Wait a minute. C is a child and not a parent. Why does this work? Well, it works because the compiler knows it can do such upcasts. Parent is kind of the parent class, so it's inherited with a public interface here to the child. So that allows you to use a child wherever a parent is used. Yeah, so I can then call this function pc.hello. That will in fact print parent. So as we know that this PC reference is of type child, we can use a static cast and say I want to change PC to be not a parent reference, but a child reference, and I assign it. Then I call the function. So note here, comes now where we see the limitations of static cast. I have here a parent P1 object, and now I cast it statically to a child reference, and then I call the function. This will output here child, but note that a parent is not a child, only a child is a parent. So this is in fact wrong code. It will work in this example for implementation detailed reasons, but it's actually not safe. So you should not cast an object such as parent to one of its child classes or descendants somewhere in the object-oriented hierarchy. That's not right. Therefore, we have the dynamic cast. To use dynamic cast, we have to make the parent polymorph. So here we have to declare a virtual destructor, for example. We can use any other method that is, we just have to use one method that is virtual. Now this class here is polymorph, and so is the whole hierarchy inheriting from it. So child is polymorph as well as parent. So now this is basically the runtime type information providing that I need. Now I can, if I use example before, like before, parent p1, I say dynamic cast this to a child reference, the compiler will throw at runtime a bad cast exception. And we know how to catch it. So in my main function, I have a try catch block here. I try to use a code with the dynamic cast function here that does this invalid operation. And then I call catch the exception and print out a reason.